हरे कृष्णा। डोंट जस्ट टॉक अबाउट द अदर, टॉक विद द अदर। द अदर रेफर्स टू सम पर्सन, सम ग्रुप, सम पर्सन और सम यूनिट विथ व्हिम वी हैव सम डिफरेंसेस। नाउ मेनी टाइम्स व्हेन वी हैव सम प्रॉब्लम विथ समवन, इवन इफ दैट प्रॉब्लम इज कॉज्ड बाय दैट पर्सन्स रॉन्ग बिहेवियर, often we talk about our grievances with a third person who seems to commiserate with us, who sympathizes with us, but who doesn't actually do anything to solve the problem. And often by such talking only the negative vibrations increase, and sometimes such talking can even become backbiting and gossiping, wherein if what we feel are our grievances are based on misanalysis of the situation, wherein the other person is not actually to be blamed, but there are other factors involved which we did not take into consideration. So the often by talking about the other, oh, you know, that person said like that, you know, that person did like that, you know what that person did that time, no, we can create a whole network of problems through which there we can go. We can create a network of perceptions, illusions and misconceptions that only aggravate the situation, that do nothing to solve the problem. But instead, if you just, quite often, if you just approach directly, talk with the other, talk to the other, talk with the other, and we understand where the other person is coming from, what that other person's thoughts are, what that person's situation is, then quite often we get a better handle on how to deal with the situation. It's not that just by talking with the other person the problem may be solved. The problem may still be there, but still we get a better understanding of the situation by direct communication. So on the other hand, if especially when we are dealing with we are talking about not people who are outright enemies, but people with whom we have overall good relationships. But there have been some niggling misunderstandings or suspicions or sore spots for whatever reason in the relationship. So it's best to have direct communication and have clarification and set the proper channel and keep the relationship on a footing of that is mutually intelligible. It's not that we will share all our understandings with others or others will share our understandings with us, but at least if we know where who stands, then we can have intelligible communication and the relationship can come at continue at an appropriate footing when there is this mutual intelligibility. So intelligibility doesn't mean necessarily agreement, but we understand, okay, why did this person do like this? Okay, because that person is like this and that person thought like that. And we at least have some understanding of what the other person is coming about. So on the other hand, when we just talk about the other, then we gossip, we backbite, and we just create so much negative vibrations which ruin the relationships. So Krishna guides us in the Bhagavad Gita when he talks about austerity of speech in 17.15, that anudvega karam vakyam satyam priyahitam chayat स्वाध्यायाभ्यसनं चैव वाङ्मयं तप उच्यते. सो ही सेज अनुद्वेगकरं वाक्यं ही सेज स्पीक वर्ड दैट डू नॉट एजिटेट अदर, सत्यं प्रियहितं च यत, दैट स्पीक ट्रूथफुल वर्ड, स्पीक व्हिच आर प्लीजिंग एंड व्हिच आर बेनिफिशियल टू अदर्स. सो इफ वी सी ऑल दिस दैट ही इज टॉकिंग अबाउट, दिस इज एसेंशियली हिज टॉक अबाउट हाउ वी शुड स्पीक in a way that furthers communication, not in a way that furthers misconception. So by talking, one way we can fulfill this purpose, one way that I can speech can be non-agitating, truthful, beneficial, pleasing, is if we establish proper channels and forums for communication with others, and we talk to each other. By talking to each other, again, I'm not saying it's not that problems will be solved, but at least mutual positions will be understood, and then thereby the actions can be evaluated based on understanding of where a person is coming from, rather than just based on gossip. So by not succumbing to the temptation to gossip or backbite, or to just wallow in mutual self-pity at how bad the other person is, by talking with each other, talking with the other, we find that the other is also quite similar to us. That ultimately that person is also a human being, that person is also a person with feelings, with aspirations, which are largely like ours, and thus we can relate with them and we can understand them and move towards a stronger relationship, or at least a less fractious, less suspicious, less troublesome relationship. And in that way, we can avoid agitating the minds of others and also avoid agitating our own minds. Thank you. Hare.